In the late 40s, the Naval Nuclear Propulsion Program was pretty much started by one man, Hyman Rickover, who at the time was a captain. He had this great idea to put a nuclear reactor in a submarine, so that way it didn't have to surface all the time. It didn't have to come in and refuel all the time. Fast forward to over 50 years later, and now we've been operating submarines and aircraft carriers safely with nuclear power. We've never had a reactor accident. We've got an outstanding safety record. And the naval nuclear fleet serves as a model to the civilian sector. Hi, I'm Jesse Sloan. I am a lieutenant junior grade in the United States Navy, and I'm a naval reactors engineer. As a naval reactors engineer, our overall mission is to make sure that the nuclear reactors operating on submarines and aircraft carriers maintain safe and reliable operation, propulsion. We've been operating reactors for over 50 years now. And the only way that we've been able to do that is through the diligence of naval reactors to make sure that all of our designs are safe and that we can maintain the fleet. Good naval reactors engineer, someone who's done really well in school, has a very good foundation of science and technology. The work that we put out has to maintain a very high standard. We are the leaders of the nuclear power industry. In order to become a naval reactors engineer, first you have to graduate from college with a bachelor's degree in science and technology field. While you're still in college, usually within a year or two of graduating, you go through an interview process. You go to Naval Reactors Headquarters and you interview with some of the engineers there. In the afternoon, you meet with the four-star admiral who runs the naval nuclear program. Then you get a commission as a Navy officer, go to officer training for 5 weeks, and report to Naval Reactors Headquarters for your first assignment. After about a year, which consists of working your daily job, doing some in-the-office training, you're sent away to Bettis Reactor Engineering School for about 6 months, followed by a month of touring our shipyards and research facilities. The Navy has a lot of great programs to help pay for college. One of them is the Nuclear Propulsion Officer Candidate Program. The income that you receive while in the NUPOC program, while you're finishing school, is great. It means that you can spend your time focusing on your homework, focus on your studying, focus on some kind of workout program. At the Bettis Reactor Engineering School, you spend about 23, 24 weeks studying 11 different graduate level classes, everything from mathematics to nuclear physics, heat transfer systems, thermodynamics, structural mechanics, reactor theory, and all of it at once. So I think at one point I was taking 8 or 9 classes at the same time. So it's challenging. There is a very, very large amount of information. It's like drinking from a fire hose, the amount of information that they throw at you. After you complete the training, you're stationed back at Naval Reactors Headquarters, where you work in an office environment about a 8 o'clock in the morning to 5 o'clock in the afternoon schedule. Spend a lot of the day reading technical submittals, talking to our research laboratories, writing a lot of technical responses. I love most about my job that I get to go home every night and see my family. The actual work environment is great. I work with some amazing people, and right now it seems like a dream job. There's a lot of new designs coming in for review and approval. We get to get our hands dirty in a lot of hardcore engineering work. We interact a lot with the civilian sector, constantly on the phone with them, visiting their sites, having them visit Naval Reactors Headquarters. In addition, there's a lot of civilians who work at Naval Reactors Headquarters. We're a mix between military and civilian. There's lots of career opportunities after your initial 5-year commitment as a Naval Reactors Engineer. You can stay in the Navy, or you can convert to civilian and maybe stay on at Naval Reactors in a civilian position, or leave the Naval Reactors community and work for a defense contractor, work for a nuclear power plant in the civilian sector. There are really endless possibilities. Everything that we do at Naval Reactors really has to be the best product that we put out. And so I try to take that to heart and just be a better person overall. And that includes pursuing graduate degrees. The Navy is paying for me to get my master's degree in nuclear engineering. Thank you for watching the webcast. I hope you've learned a lot about what a Naval Reactors engineer does. And if you have any more questions, find us on Facebook or go to Navy.com.